Greetings, Moro people. Peace and grace in the name of the risen Christ in this season of Easter. We trust that you are well in the spirit this morning and welcome you to this service of celebration, bringing our whole selves to God. We pray that the Spirit moves for you in a powerful way in this time of worship together.
Hear, O hear, everyone. Hear God's voice as we remember our baptism. Beloved children, I know you and have called each of you by name. From the very beginning of creation, I have loved you. Even when you lived in fear and doubt, when the way did not seem clear, I loved you and walked with you. You should know that I am always with you. I have never left you, and I never will. You are precious to me. No matter what happens in life, I am with you. You are precious to me. When you feel doubt and weakness, I am with you. When you are arrogant, I am disappointed, but I am with you. When you hurt yourself and others, I hurt with them, but I am with you, helping you to make things right, to change your fears into faith, to encourage you to know my presence, to be part of the workers for peace that are so sorely needed here. I ask for you to trust me, to find ways to serve which are healing and bring hope to people. Here today, we join together to give God our praise and thanks for our baptism covenant.
Baptized in water.
So I want to tell you about something special that I keep with me in my car at all times. Can you guess what it might be? I know some people keep maps, some people keep first aid kits, some people keep special tools in case they break down or have a flat tire. But me, I carry a special bag that contains rocks. Yeah, stones. Some of them are big, some of them are big rocks. But each one is collected from a place or collected at a special time in my life that reminds me of a story. And those stories are all about times when I felt God's spirit, God's presence that I couldn't see and sometimes I couldn't hear, but I knew was there taking care of me. And I keep it in my car because that's the time when I want to make sure I am reminded that God is always with me. It reminds me of the time when my children were baptized and I felt God with me saying, "It's okay, Mama, I've got these kids, I've got this baby. This baby is mine and ours, and together we're gonna raise this baby up to be a young person and a young adult, and then a big person and a big adult. And they're going to be okay. They're going to do good things. They're with me." That kind of story is really important in all of our lives because there are times when we don't always feel like we're going to be okay. And there's times when we're not sure what's going to happen next. I keep a stone with me all the time in my pocket. And when I worry a little bit, I rub it. Just to make sure I'm reminded that God's spirit just wraps around me and I know love all the time. I hope you'll think about collecting something, a stone or a shell or something else entirely, but something that reminds you that God is always with you and you know God's spirit is moving through you to bring goodness and love to the world. Will you think about what you might want to collect? I'll show you my bag of rocks next time we get together and we can compare and share stories of all the time we knew God was with us. Let's do that together, okay? Amen and amen.
I want to take men down to the levee, take men down to the stream. Take men down to the water, we're gonna wash our souls clean. Take men down to the river, take men down to the lake. Yes, we'll all go together, we're gonna do it for the good Lord's sake.
During baptism, everyone gathered commits to nurture the child in the church and to teach and lead by example. At Mara, we begin with our youngest children, teaching the stories of the Bible and immersing children in God's love and grace. During confirmation, students have the opportunity to make their baptismal covenant their own, and Mara continues to teach. To provide opportunities for them to stand up against evil in this world, to provide opportunities for them to grow in understanding of their role in systems of oppression and injustice and find ways to resist them. And we continue to journey with them as they grow in faith and love of God and to return to the healing waters of grace when they need forgiveness and love. The generosity of Mara's members, sharing their prayers, presence, gifts, service, and witness to lead and teach has always been a strength. More than ever, our children and students need this strength and God's spirit to surround them as they journey into complicated times ahead. Mara continues to need and utilize your gifts for this critical ministry. Thank you. Thank you for your time, your listening, your leadership, your financial support, as we all live into our commitment to nurture and teach our children. We will always work to immerse them in the water of God's grace and your love. Praise God, from whom all blessings, like our baptismal waters, flow.
Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Alleluia, alleluia. Praise God, the source of all our gifts. Praise Jesus Christ, whose power uplifts. Praise the Spirit, Holy Spirit. Alleluia.
Friends, I came home from recording worship to exciting and good news. Good morning. Today it is my responsibility to share with you the news that Morrow's certified candidate for ministry, Joon Hee Yoon, will be appointed to serve as the new pastor for Waterloo United Methodist Church in Waterloo, New Jersey, effective July 1st, 2021. Transition is always a difficult time, and I ask you to be in prayer with Joon Hee and her family and the Waterloo United Methodist Church. I want to take this opportunity to thank Joon Hee for her faithful leadership and participation at Morrow Church. Joon Hee was a classmate of mine. She has been a faithful attendee of the 8:30 service of worship at Morrow. She has prayed with us and for us, and she has been a part of one of our most important small groups in the life of the church. While saying goodbye is always difficult, we want Joon Hee to know that we and she will be in our prayers with her family as she prepares for a new chapter in her ministry. God's grace and peace go with Joon Hee and her family. Friends, this is a very exciting time. One of the most exciting moments in the life of our students and friends and colleagues and coworkers. Celebrate the firm foundation and the ground that we have provided for Joon Hee. On this day, when we celebrate the meaning of our baptism, the baptism and the commitments that are made on that special Sunday, the confirmation vows we take, the membership vows we take, and yes, the process and path to ordination that some of us are on. Thank you for being the church and supporting all of us who are a part of the work of ministry. Day by day by day, we are all called to ministry. Claim the call that's on your own life.
So good to see you all today. Here are announcements. This Sunday, today, at 12 noon, we will have an opportunity for our confirmands to join together with Pastor Janice for a meeting at 12 noon outside on Baker Street Lawn. We're looking forward to hearing from her and for sharing all it is about our church, our denomination, our faith. And we are excited that our camps are planned and up and running. Registration is on our website. Please take a look at that and send any of your neighbors or friends to our website to register. We have opportunities for students in preschool through finishing grade 12, and we are grateful for all the work that people are doing. And we have opportunities for more people to join us in the fun. Any adults, college students, or high school students that are interested in working with our younger children this summer, please take a look at those opportunities, sign up, and join us. We have a great team and we're excited. Our chapel garden service begins June 6th at 8:30 in the morning, an opportunity to gather early on Sunday and be outdoors in nature, led by Pastor Janis in the Memorial Garden, a beautiful time of gathering and prayer. We are also looking forward to new opportunity with the Benjamins. Rachel and Jason Benjamin have begun a new ministry called Pray and Play, a chance for parents and kids in preschool up through age 10 to get together and play together, and for parents to share and for everyone to come together for a time of prayer. The next gathering is going to be May 22nd on Sunday afternoon. Take a look on the website for more information about where to meet. And please come out. It's a great time to connect again, to see each other, to remember who we are as a community that loves our kids and loves God. We're grateful for them. And we are so wonderfully gifted by a hotel that has closed its doors but given its linens to our turnover sale. So please take a look on our website for links to buy linens, high quality, beautiful materials that are not destined now for a dump or for garbage, but instead to grace our homes with their beauty. Please share that information with your family and friends so that they too can participate in supporting the ministries of our congregation and also have some beautiful linens in their homes as well. Today, SPRC meets next Sunday at 4:30. We're grateful for the work that they do, and we're encouraging everyone to also support an upcoming concert from Chris Matthews. That'll be on June 25th, outdoors in the parking lot at Mara Church. Take a look online for their wonderful ministry of music and join us and make sure your friends and family know. It's gonna be a wonderful time of music, celebration, and sharing. Those are our announcements for today.
It is always good to be with you. And I am so grateful for the many gifts of the leadership of this church. I know that Pastor Brenda worked hard to bring a message about baptism for our offering today. I know how Holland works week after week after week to recruit you all to sing. And I know how day by day by day we pray over money received, your lives, your worry. And so will you, on this day of the Lord, join me in a word of prayer this morning. Gracious and most holy God, it is true that we begin our journey here. In the sacrament of baptism, we all remember that the vow that was made on our behalf. Maybe we were babies, or maybe we were older kids. Maybe we were baptized as adults because we hadn't been baptized before. Remind the world that we are still in the business of baptism, bestowing your love and care and protection upon the lives of your people. An outward and visible sign and ritual to the gathered community of faithful people that allows us to remember, that allow us to make vows to support and uphold your church, and to vow to surround and support families and children on their journey of growth. And so, Lord, it's good this day to pray through our own stories. It's good, Lord, this day that we would remember where we are, what next steps we might want to take on our faith journey, that we might be ready for the prophetic texts of Scripture that remind us that you are constantly calling us and leading us to do something new, to include more people, to bless more people,
with your love and grace and power, your protection and care. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here. Remind us that we need to receive it to be bold and strong for all that's going on in our own lives, for our families and for our workplaces, for our community and for your world, for your created order of beautiful flowers and birds that we want to protect, for the work of justice for all people. For we know that as we heal and are saved, we do not do it alone or for ourselves alone. We are together in community as the sun shines bright and comes out from behind the clouds. We pray this day in the very sweet and powerful name of Jesus, mindful of the people in India, mindful of those in this country who fear going out for a jog or a drive, and vowing to seek your guidance and your will, because this is the work of the gospel. Thank you. And as we pray these words on this day, we dare sing together the words you taught us to pray.
The victory. The Lord has made known his victory. His righteousness has he openly shown in the sight of the nations. He remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel. And all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice and sing. Sing to the Lord with the harp and the voice of song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Shout with joy before the King, the Lord. Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the land. lands and those who dwell therein. Let the rivers clap their hands, and let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord when he comes to judge the earth. In righteousness shall he judge the world and the peoples with equity. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Alleluia.
Today's scripture reading comes from the book of Acts, chapter 10, verses 44 through 48. While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles, for they had heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" So he ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for several days. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Gracious and most holy God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be ever acceptable unto you. May the work of this church be aligned with the work that we see and read about in your holy word. May you continue to bless each and every one of us by and through the message and day by day by day by day. We are grateful for the privilege of being baptized Christians, for having a church community and a place to be and to become whole. We pray always in the name of the one who is creator and redeemer and sustainer, and say thank you, Lord, and amen. I love the story about the Pentecostal man who wandered into a United Methodist church During the sermon, the visitor got so excited that whenever the United Methodist preacher made a point, the Pentecostal man would scream and shout, "Praise God! Hallelujah! Amen!" And the ushers were so concerned about the Pentecostals' outbursts that the lead usher went down to where the visitor was sitting and shouting and whispered to him, "You'll have to keep quiet. The pastor's right in the middle of her sermon." To which the visitor said, "Keep quiet? In the middle of the sermon? I've got the Holy Spirit in me." To which the usher replied, "Well, you didn't get it here." And United Methodist preachers everywhere pray for a few Pentecostals, just a handful of alleluias and amens on Sunday morning. The book of Acts reads like a Pentecostal manifesto of baptisms, the spirits moving, speaking in tongues, and ecstatic expressions of faith. But the book also reads like a blueprint for progressive churches like ours, where God's Holy Spirit is constantly revealing the new thing that God wants from us, the often unexpected, maybe unwanted new thing, the new thing that some might call unbiblical in the Bible, gestures of inclusion and equity and radical new ways of understanding the rules in the church. But it does depend on how we read it, if we read it, if we care about what the Bible says anymore, and how we justify and celebrate who God calls us to be together in the life of the church. It's probably true that we all read and see what we want to see. What I want to see is the Spirit's moving in power and powerful acts of change in the life of the early Christian community. Changes that allow us to claim and proclaim the change we make today, that we want to make to happen now. How that lady is preaching in the pulpit, and what's up with that rainbow flag, and why all the politics? Exactly what the Spirit is moving us to do. The book of Acts begins with Jesus ascending and sending the Spirit in chapter 2. The Spirit falls on everyone gathered, and everyone gathered, the multilingual, multicultural community understood in their own language. I think that's a clue to what the Spirit wants to do. Earlier in today's chapter 10, Peter saw visions, shocking, law-challenging visions, and he cannot believe what God's Spirit is saying. Eat the meat that for centuries you have understood as off-limits. And now, the Jewish believers are witnessing the non-discriminating Holy Spirit fall upon the Gentiles, the non-Jewish people, who are then being baptized. Up to this point, the Gentiles had to become Jewish to become Christian. So this baptism of the uncircumcised probably appeared as an insulting, corner-cutting move, dismissive of the tradition. But Peter's convinced. Ritual washing wasn't new to the Hebrew people, but in the more ancient culture, and truthfully in the Roman Empire that would follow, washing was tied to purity laws, which led to a hierarchy and a separation of who was in and who was out. Ritual purity, while a defining part of the survival of the Hebrew people community, a people set apart, also became a hierarchy and a separation of those considered polluted or contaminated, and the unclean were shunned. It's also true that in the Old Testament, long before Peter and Paul engaged the Gentiles, the prophet Isaiah said that Israel would be a light to the Gentiles. The Gentiles, a name that's been used to include the excluded, the unclean, those people, today's them. We learn to make no distinction, to not withhold baptism of water and the Spirit from anyone, because there is no hierarchy, no separation, no lines, no better or worse. And in the earliest Christian baptismal covenant in Galatians 3:28, we read there, in Christ there is no east or west, no slave nor free, no male and female. But it took Christians a long time to take action on the issue of slavery, for people to no longer be held or sold as property. And yet women and children are still sold into prostitution around the globe today. The Spirit is still moving us. The more present debate is around sexual orientation. Even with all the messages of inclusion in the early church, even with the stories of the laws being uplifted, even with all that we have learned about the burden that we as Christians put on people who are different from ourselves, but the Spirit is still moving. And it's why we work for Black Lives to Matter. It's why we work to understand what it means to be anti-racist, because the Spirit is still moving. The Holy Spirit is still moving. And in the early church, tells us exactly how it is to move, to tear down the walls and the barriers of separation, to make freedom and equity for all and baptize them all with the love and care and protection of God. You might be struggling this morning. And we might prefer to not be challenged. We might prefer that the Spirit would align with what Grandma taught us, or Dad did, or the happy God who wants us to be rich, like the preacher on TV is saying. But to me, that doesn't feel like real power. There's room for us to be moved, to bear witness. And imagine its power on our lives, for our lives, for all the ways that we have felt separated in the church and outside, all the ways that we might feel broken, for our children, for the future, for all, for the fear and the judgment we've experienced. We receive the power of the Holy Spirit. Christian men and women are marked by baptism. And those converting to Judaism are still washing. Those practicing Islam use a ritual washing of great respect and honor as they ground themselves in prayer many times a day. Just as we baptize Andrea Rose Hernandez this morning, grandniece of Marina and Joe Ford, whose granddad sits with Jesus and watches from the heavens, that she might know God's Spirit's power of protection and care and claim it and receive it for her own. We renew the promises made at ours. And the church is the primary place where all the sacramental work is done, where we invoke and evoke and hopefully provoke the power and protection of God, where the rules that have shut people out before are lifted. How many people are missing out on a community of love, a giant great family to raise their kids within, an amazing place to sing and study, to learn and pray? We receive the Holy Spirit again and again and again. Can I get an amen? If you are new to our video this morning and you have questions about this message, call us, write us, reach out to us so that we can share all that we've learned, all that we've prayed through, the ways that we've tapped our own stories, our experience, the reason, our minds, our hearts, and all that we've learned about the tradition of the church, that we might interpret the scriptures in a way of justice and inclusion, equity and freedom for all. Thank you for being with us this day. Alleluia, amen, and amen. As you go forth from your screens today, will you click close, shut down, and go out. Know that the Holy Spirit has been poured out upon you. If you're struggling, call your church. Seek your pastors. We are here to be on this journey with you. We are here to be in Bible study with you. Go out into the world that is your life, knowing and claiming and proclaiming the love and protection of in care of God that we receive in our baptism. Go in the name of the one who is creator and redeemer, and the one who will sustain us for all time. Amen.